Living the dream now on BBC One, the rise and rise of footballer David Healy.
As a boy, you know, I always wanted to play football for the biggest club in the world, which I'm here at the minute. People are going to always have high expectations of somebody who plays for Manchester United. Just, it comes with, you know, the name. You know, it's known all over the world and things like that. So it is difficult, you know, it's hard to get a chance, and just hopefully when the chance comes, you know, I'm ready to take it.
David Healy has been an outstanding prospect as a striker. He has made a remarkable start. To score the goals that he has in four or five internationals is something quite phenomenal.
He's got everything in place, level-headed boy, good footballer, and he knows where the net is.
Healy, nice feet, nice control.
You know he's got the talent, he puts himself about, he's a good lad, you know, he works hard, and he'll get his just rewards.
Plays up front, very, very sharp, very quick, good little player.
Two great feet, understands the game very well, good attitude to his, a winning attitude, and really, that I think they should have a really good career.
You've got to be tough, and when you get out there, you got to show people that you know you're here to work and here to want to be the best.
The theatre of dreams. So many young boys from Northern Ireland long to play for a club like Manchester United. David Healy, the boy from Killyleagh, is just one who shares that dream.
Killyleagh's a very small little town. Growing up, you know, I was always kicking the ball. My mum used to say I used to go to sleep with the ball when I was maybe 2, 3, 4. So even then, you know, my mum sort of says, you know, you were dedicated to football.
He would have got up in the morning and got a crowd of boys and away down to the showgrounds, taking penalty kicks, coming back up again with his pockets down to his knees with 10p that he had won in penalties. But I mean, that was 9 o'clock in the morning to 9 o'clock at night.
Killyleagh, under 12s, I think it was only maybe 7. He used to put me on last 2 or 3 minutes just to keep me happy that I went in that. Then after a couple of years there, I went to Crossgar Youth when I was maybe 9 or 10.
He started to play for Crossgar, was doing well, scoring a lot of goals, and a friend of ours, Morris Garrett, approached the Manchester United scout from Lisburn, Eddie Coulter, and said to Eddie about him, and Eddie advised him to come to Lisburn Youth and play there.
David, as a boy, was outstanding goal scorer. Outstanding. What a finisher the boy was. A bit exceptional, actually. In 1 year, I remember he scored 170 goals in one season.
I remember him as a very steady pupil, a very conscientious pupil. It was clear from a very early stage that he was a very talented young man, and even just in a bit of a kickabout in the yard at lunchtime, he had skills way beyond some of the other people that were playing with him, you know.
I wasn't bad at school, but I wasn't saying I was brilliant at school, you know, maybe could have better results than I did. But as soon as United wanted me, you know, I just wanted to get over and play football.
Me and Morris Garrett left David up to the airport that day, and it's a funny one, you know, Morris said to me, "Don't you be crying up here, big fella?" And it was actually Morris was crying more than me.
I think my mum was a bit worried, you know, I was leaving home when I'd be 16. I think she was maybe a bit worried, you know, it was maybe a bit too soon and that. But as soon as, you know, you get away and that, you know, you just settle yourself in and just take it from there. At the start, you know, maybe first couple of weeks, month, couple of months, you do start thinking about home, you know. But once you start getting settled in, you just think, you know, I'm over here on my own. Got to work hard, you know. Your parents are just phone call away, so, you know, it's not as if they're on the other side of the planet.
We're all worried and sort of, you know, that your son's leaving home at 15 and you don't know what's going to be, you know, happen with him across the water. It's, football's very hard over there.
Even as a 14-year-old, the manager at Sir Alex Ferguson says, don't worry about your little boy, to my mum, you know, we'll look after him, you know, this is a family club, everybody's treated the same, everybody will be the same.
Being away from home is always difficult. At 15, you know, it's a little bit scary, and going to Manchester seemed like the other end of the world to a young kid, and it was a little bit, it was very difficult, you know, because we were a very close family. And I find it very difficult, which is why I come home almost immediately. But fortunately, you know, I got over it, as we all have to do, living away from home. And I was lucky, I had nice digs and a lovely landlady, and you know, you got to knuckle down and get used to it.
I had supported Manchester United from an early age. There was definitely no other club for me. You know, I had thought about Rangers because I had supported Rangers as a boy. But as soon as United were in, you know, the club, the people, it was just for me.
With the wealth of talent knocking at the door of Old Trafford, it's hard enough to make an impression at the best of times. As a young boy from Northern Ireland, it's even more difficult as comparisons with George Best are inevitable. Following in the footsteps of one of the world's greatest footballers is a heavy burden for any young player.
George Best is just, you know, I think he's still everybody's hero. Some of the things he used to do on the pitch was, you know, just unbelievable. You know, you have to see him. My dad says when he did watch him, he was not a player like him. Definitely my idol, you know, he was the best, you know. Unfortunately, I didn't get to see him. I was just too young.
I achieved everything that I dreamt of doing as a kid, and I was like all kids, all I dreamt about was playing football. And basically Manchester United were the first club that watched me. When I first got in the team, it was amazing because Sir Matt didn't even tell me I was playing until maybe a couple of hours before kickoff. So it came as a complete surprise, and luckily I got in. And it was a bit of a culture shock because the following week I was back in the junior sides after playing in the first team. And then a couple of months later I got back in the team and unfortunately stayed around for another lovely 10 years.
Going forward is free at the moment. There's Best, a good move.
There's nobody in British football at the moment you could compare with George Best. George Best was so far in advance of all of us that there's no way that we could hope to have another George Best. As far as I'm concerned, for many, many, many years, he's just a one-off. But Healy, I think, has been the most positive striker that we've had for the last 3 or 4 decades.